Hello and welcome to the Edge of Midnight channel. I am Jason, your host. Yes, I am. I am the crazy one. Okay. Now, I'm going to make it meat and potato pie. I'm going to cheat. I'm going to use certain ingredients. Oh, that's doggies as well. But I know from experience it's going to be good. I'm going to share it with next door. Let me get the big. That's what it's going in. Not the best pan, but doesn't matter. That's where it's going. First, I need potatoes. Come in, you two. You're being too loud. Let me go check what the post was. Okay, sorry about that. That was just the post. So let's see. Let's have a look what we've got. We need potatoes, carrots, and onions. Let me think, is there anything else in here? Yes, I'll get some butter out. I'll get some milk out. There. We have milk, moo, margarine, although I might use the butter. Onions, carrots, potatoes. Okay, let's open up potatoes. Let's move that out of the way now. And okay. Unfortunately, as I've said before, I don't follow recipes. I follow instinct. I believe anybody can be a cook. Anybody can learn. If you taste, if you try something, what's the worst that's going to happen? You're going to ruin one meal. So what? You can always order takeout. I would always prefer to try and fail than to not try at all. So, I never pick or have. Oh, let's put that down. Yeah, I'm getting distracted again. I was looking at the potato and thinking, yeah, I could use that for something else. Don't ask me what. I'm not peeling them, I'm just quartering them. Yes, me and knives have a long tradition. I play with them, they cut me. It happens a lot. This is why we have two or three first aid kits in the house. Now, really, we had the first aid kits for power, but okay, so let's see. Oh, this has got going to be big enough for two houses. There. See, just guesstimating. Let's put this back. Sorry, that took a while to thingy. A tomato fell down the back of the cupboard in there. Right, okay. All the bits and pieces. Let's get some water in this. That'll be enough. Get this on to start with. Oh, I just need to do that first, it's not going to. Then in that one. That'll do. Put the lid on so it'll hang you right. Du-du-du-du. I also don't do times and sorting out that kind of thing. Now I want to do some carrots, so carrots next. Carrots, carrots, carrots. Also, carrots, I don't dip pre clean, so I don't get rid of the skin because a lot of the goodness is in the skin. And yes, I'm very bluntly cutting these, I'm not doing it anything fancy. Cut myself yet today. I don't put that much of it in, and now we're going to add an onion. I'll be back, I'm just going to get the skin off the onion. Come in. Hey Trevor.
Alright, I'm off.
Okay.
I go straight to the allotment.
Yeah. Let me know how she is.
Okay, I'll be back about. Five-ish.
Yeah, food will be ready now.
Five or six anyway. I'm not strict.
I'll bring you some over in a cupboard thing. Yeah, that's your pretty quality.
Yeah. My new one.
Yeah. Okay.
It means I can use it abroad without any charges. Apparently.
I will see you later.
Okie dokie. I'll go.
That was Trevor. Recording.
Oh, okay.
Yes, let's see. That was Trevor. Right. Put that on, put the lid on. We need some salt in there. Where's my salt? That's not. This'll do. Don't usually put much salt at all in there. I am not. I like a bit of salt. But I don't overdo it. Alright, so. Right, let's look at the other ingredients. I can put this lot away. Throw away bits. Beryl, that is just Trevor going to his car. He's allowed to go to his car. He owns the car. Trevor is a nice guy. Have I put everything away that needs to go away? I think so. Anyway, to give me room for the rest of the stuff. So, this is going to have potatoes, carrots, onions. And we're going to cheat with the meat. The cheapest version of these tins of stewed steak. Just two of them are going to go in it. I don't have the money to get in proper steak and all that anyway. So, and I'm going to cheat with the puff pastry. But one of these rolls of puff pastry, which will be perfect. I'll get it out so you can go to room temperature better. I should have taken it out earlier. I'll just put that over there, that'll be fine. One day, I'm going to do a lobby. Now a lobby may sound weird, everything I do sounds weird. A lobby is a traditional Staffordshire stew. It comes from the end of the war. when people didn't have much money. And the idea was this. All the little town streets, each street would do it, would get a tin bath, put it over an open flame, and lob stuff in, throw stuff in. Somebody would throw in a potato. Another person would throw in a little tiny bit of meat they had left. Someone would put in something else. And it was called a lobby. And then when it was all cooked up, everybody ate from it. So there isn't any exact recipe for a lobby. The way I was taught by my father will be different than anybody else in Staffordshire. It's got lots of vegetables, but the meat can be bacon, it can be sausage, it can be beef burgers, you can put beef burgers in it. It can be any kind of meat you would want. And vegetables, whatever you want. Herbs, spices, you name it. Lobbies work very well as a long-term meal. Basically, you cook it up, and everybody will tell you this who tries a lobby. The first bowlful will taste nice. When you grab a bowlful 6 hours later, it'll taste better. I used to do huge lobbies, and me and Paolo would eat it all through the day. And then I'd freeze up what was left. Well, yeah, I didn't get this from any specific recipe. I just Paola liked a pie now and then, and Trevor always liked the pies I did. Get some gravy granules and some stock because we'll need them. I'm going to put some dark soy sauce in. Don't ask me why, but it sounds fun. Mixed herbs might go in. Some pepper. Oh, what else? I don't need to put too much else in. Yeah, I've got my stock cubes there. I'm all very random when it comes to food. This pie will not be like any other pie I've done. It all follows the same kind of idea, but it doesn't. I need to do this. I've got a timer on these two now. Set you. You need to be on for about 30 minutes, so. And you need to be on for about 30 minutes. I need them to be quite mushy. Don't worry, I won't. I'm not going to do a video that long. And even if I did, I'd have other things to show you. Right. What do we do? I'm trying to think of what else I would add to this meal. I might add a tin of beans. Yeah, I might add a tin of baked beans. Some people hate baked beans, some people like baked beans. I like them. Let's move this around a little bit. That's my Berkey. For Paola, I always had a Berkey because the particulate matter in water, seeing as she can only drink water, I double filtrated it. I didn't need to, I put it through the Berkey and then I put it through a normal filter. And that's the water that she will have drank. I enjoyed sitting outside last night. I need to sort out the actual way that this works. I'm going to just let them thingy and go for a little walk around the house. We shall walk around the house, Yes, I'll probably do a lobby in that, the Instapot, because that's it does everything that does. It's a blooming pressure cooker. It'll do yogurt and everything, porridge. Oh, I can't have porridge anymore. What the hell, universe? Porridge just is not good for me. I talk about my mental problems, but let's go outside. It's cold out here. It's only about 6 to 7 degrees. Ooh, it is cold, and I've only got a t-shirt on. Right. I need to get the poops up. The dogs are poopied. Yay. Stuff under there. Paula's old walker. And that red and chrome, that is my old, what I used to use with the wheel so I could use it on the Xbox One. I have it set up on the PC though more now. But yeah. My physical problems are probably more embarrassing than my mental problems. It's weird though, isn't it? I've lost 40%. Ooh, we haven't been in here. Paula's wheelchair's in here. Her old wheelchair. You'll notice it's got pneumatic tyres. It was our adventure chair because it could go off-road. And Paula's and mine's air rifle when we went shooting. She had a special small air rifle that allowed... Oh, I'll show you them. No, I won't. No, I won't get them. I'll get them out another time. My old CB. Yes, that's an actual CB. Old food. I always used to store food in here, just in case. My toolkit for the boat. My toolkit for the boat. My Draper toolkit for the boat. What's in there? What little toys have I stuck away? Oh wow. And that table there that's folded up, that was a table that was out permanently over her bed so I could do the dialysis stuff. Right, hello doggy! Hello Bertie! Bertie! Sit down, little boo-boo. You're boo-boo, aren't you? You're a good doggy. You're beautiful. You're a beautiful little doggy. Yes, you are. Let's see. I need to let this drain tonight, the ice machine. So I can give you a good clean. Oh, I've got my stomach. Always used to use that outside. Still got some paraffin in it. Now, what's in this cupboard? It's a mess, this cupboard is at the moment. This used to be the medical cupboard. It's got everything in, literally everything needs to be sorted. Right. You know this bamboo, this huge monstrous bamboo, started at a simple tiny shoot we picked up from town and the guy didn't know whether it'd actually grow. And look at it, it's everywhere. I need to cut it down or move it to a different room. There's only two plants in this entire place that have survived. That's the... Oh, I don't know who's going past with that beep beep. This is where the hygienic wipes went, and every time I came in the kitchen after, when I was doing Paula's wound or anything, I had to wash my hands. That was the Hibby scrub. Hydrex surgical scrub. Turns your skin as thin as paper. You have to use moisturiser with it or you will be in a bad way. This is my Mighty Mug. I have two Mighty Mugs. They're brilliant for not falling over and that. I love them. I got two because one was never enough. Plus, they keep ice really well. So when I go up to stream, I'll fill both of them up with water and a little bit of juice and some ice and sit them next to my computer so I can actually... It's the only cups that I feel safe having next to my computer because I am a bit accident prone. Let's go in the living room and see. My pictures of Paola. Paola's ashes. I haven't done anything with it yet. I don't know whether I feel up to it yet. Hello, Bertie. You're on your seat. Their couch. No, little baby. Are you going to climb over the seat onto my seat? Because you're cheeky. You're cheeky, aren't you? You're a cheeky little doggy. Yes, you are. Give me a paw. Give me a paw. Good doggy. You're so beautiful. You're a love sponge, aren't you? You could be stroked all day. Hello, Beryl. Yay. Beryl, Beryl, Beryl. Yeah, you're beautiful. Ah. What's the temperature inside? 20.8. Right. Now I'm going to just pause this video for now. It's going to take a while for everything to do. Ooh, we have a nice Harlequin little picture. Oh, calm down. That. When Paola used to be able to do cross stitches. Oh, these pictures always amaze me. These pictures are double-sided. She usually did a picture on one side and a picture on the other. I want to get the local college or university to come out and they might want to do something on it because what she went through and she still was able to do all this. Like she even made a Mukau lightsaber. The Moosaber. How crazy is that? And this is, she used to make me funny robots and that for on top of my computer. Yeah, you can tell. It's... This house was put together for two people. This house was put together with love. Paola loved skulls. You may have thought it would be me, but she always liked skulls. This one we bought. And that was done by one of the members of Goons. European Goonians. They got together for Paola's birthday one year and, I mean, it's gorgeous. Rex, that's Rex's ashes, our old dog. Oh, and our little Doctor Who picture that we liked. Always thought that was a nice touch. My Tennant. Yes. The reason I put these stickers up as post-it notes, because post-it notes fall off, is that each day to keep them up, I have to come in and touch them, brush them down. And by the act of doing that, I notice that I need to check on things. It's very easy for me to get lost. I have torches in every single room of the house. And they work. That's just something that came about when Paola was all, oh, what game was it? Defiance. You remember Defiance? The game, when it first came out, they found out that Paola was ill. Hellbug. So what they did was their community manager posted this to us. And that's the from Ubisoft. Oh, the wall. Let's see. Yes, I think before I trip over and kill myself, I will pause this. I can pause it. It's brilliant. This is going to probably be one of my longest videos. So I'll pause this for a little bit. So it's going to move to a different angle and now end it. Hello, we're back. I'm going to cheat some more in this. I'm doing a basic cheap vegetable soup thing is a base for the bottom of the pan. So I pour that in as the base. And then we add some pepper. Pre-ground pepper. I'll add a bit of rock salt, not much because we've just added this there. I don't think we need the baked beans. We don't need the baked beans because we've just added vegetable. Yeah. So we need some water. We need some water into it. Don't ask me how much water we got. I don't know. I don't know how long it's been. We pour some in the bottom of it. That's a good start. I've just poured it in the bottom of the thingy. There we are. Right. Ho, ho, ho. I need to add some stock. Some mixed herbs. And a little bit of dark soy sauce. Just a little bit, not too much because it can be very overpowering, so it's just a tiny bit there. Right, everything's looking good. We are focused, we are ready. We are the world. Hello, I'm Jason. I can do this. Right, so I'm going to go in and touch the tins. Grab all the meat out of there into it. I apologise if any of you are vegans or vegetarians. This is most definitely not. In fact, you will probably find hardly anything that I do. Is that? It's not that I've got anything against vegans or anything. I don't mind. Live and let live. But I don't think I could live without meat. Oh, I love meat. It's one of my. It's why I miss bacon so much. But yeah, I was telling you earlier. See, my problem is physically, my stomach had lost 40% of the colon and bowels. Not good. Not good at all. As in, not good at all. But, which has meant, basically, I'm screwed when it comes to food. If I can take certain foods, but I don't know what they are. See, it can change on a daily basis. it'll take probably an hour to cook until I put it in there. I'm going to put it on in a low heat. Yes, I don't even follow guides for the actual thing. I'm just going to stick this on the fan assisted, take you up to 165 centigrade. That'll do. That'll do, pig. That'll do. Mix all this together. Ready, waiting for the potatoes and the carrots and all the other stuff. Let's have a look at it. It looks like complete goop at the moment. Let's get a fork out and check these. That might be just starting to go soft. Right. Out of the way, Bertie. You don't want to get burnt. You don't want to trip me up. Okay, I'm going to go drain the water out of this. I can turn this one off. In fact, I can turn them both off. They're as close to being done as they're going to be. Right. So we mix these in. The onions and the carrots get mixed into it. I wish I had some mushrooms in, or some leeks. Mushrooms or leeks. I'm just going to quickly do these dishes because I don't like clean stuff. And the potatoes can just soak in the thing, so that'll be there. I don't have a dishwasher, except I am the dishwasher. This is my role in life, to be the dishwasher. Okay. Throw that away. Throw all the bits and pieces, the tins can all go. Right. We are doing well. We are focused. We have, it's almost at the stage where, right, yes. I'll just take this over here for a sec and empty all the goop out. Okay, so we've got these. Put them there for a sec. Let's wash, rinse this lid off. I am one of those people who I don't dry my washing my dishes. I always let them to dry on the actual rack. Right. I just remembered something. I no longer have a masher for mashing potatoes. I don't want them too mashed. I just want them. I'm just going to have to do a bit of stabby, stabby, stabby. You know? Stab it up a bit, make it break them down just a little bit. I don't want them burnt to the bottom because been on a hot stove, and I don't want to burn myself because that would be bad. It would not be conducive to streaming. Right. So I think that's about nice and chunky. That's gonna be nice. Well, this goes on to there. Okay. Down there to soak. Mix it all around. Mix it all in. I may put a tiny bit too much. No, I haven't put too much water in. It looks good. It's going to soak into the potatoes. The liquid is. Right. There we are. Everything's covered. Everything's down. Right. Let's have a look at it. There's the base. And then, in fact, move you over here so you can still see if I make a mistake with this. Pre-done. I like cooking for someone else. You know? And tries. It's still a bit cold, this is, but oh, what the hell? What's the worst that can happen? It can fall apart when I try and put it on. Look at that. That's just about almost perfect. Right, that is awesome. That's yay! A few holes in it. Now, if I was being fancy, I'd put some milk on top of it and all that, but it doesn't really mean it. It doesn't. This can go in the oven now. For about an hour, I will set Alexa as an alarm. So in an hour's time, while I'm streaming, I'll come off the stream and check on this. This video probably won't go up till later today or tonight because it interferes with me being able to stream. So let's open up the oven, put it in the centre shelf. Alright. There. Okay. Right, that's it's in the oven. It's in the oven. Woohoo! We can sit in there. Sit in there. Okay, so this has been Jason for the Edge of Midnight channel. I hope someone enjoys watching this. I enjoyed making. Bye bye for now. I will take a quick video when it's done to show what it's like.